So please accept me for who I am. And please accept me for what I do. I'm just doing everything that I can. Cause all I wanna be is true. So please accept me for who I am. And please accept me for what I do. To the sky, Lord, why do I cry when no one is looking? Is the blame for this pain even caused by the shame of this fame I've been given? My pride don't cause me to hide my true feelings.
Hey everybody, welcome back to 9 plus 8. My name is Amir.
My name is Kazai.
And my name is AJ.
And today we're going to be doing a hot and spicy noodle mukbang. And don't forget to subscribe, give a big thumbs up, and turn your post notifications so you don't miss any of my videos.
And if you're ever scared, frightened, and lonely, please read Isaiah 41:10. That's our final reminder.
And today we'll be drinking some water.
And our child name is Diamond Plus 8.
Family.
Yeah, family.
So let's get started.
Wait, do you want to show them where we put it?
Well, I'll just tell them. We got, crushed red peppers,
chili powder,
pepper, cayenne, and jalapeno.
And I put habanero hot sauce in mine.
Let them know that y'all made your own sauce for you.
Yeah, we made our own sauce. But it is hot.
It is.
And we could drink water because it's a mukbang.
And y'all tasted the sauce or the noodles in the sauce?
We tasted both. Well, she didn't taste the sauce. She just tasted the noodles.
Okay.
Let's play first.
Well, we know it's hot. And the camera person is TJ.
And before we start, we gotta pray.
Thank you, Lord, for this food. Make it healthy for our body. Jesus' name, thank God, amen. Thank you, God, for waking us up this morning. God, forgive us. Thank you, God, for giving us. God, bless us. Thank you, God, for blessing us. God, forgive everybody that ate before they prayed. In Jesus' name, thank God. Amen.
So we're going to start now.
Well, I think mine's way harder than yours because I put habanero hot sauce in this.
But when he put habanero hot sauce in there, I added a little bit more cayenne and all, so it could be fair.
This is but hot. Habanero, it's hotter than cayenne.
It is.
It was hot. Really hot. But when we cook our noodles, I like to keep a little bit of water in mine. Well, not a little bit, but a medium amount of water. Mm-hmm. But not too much.
I like to keep a little bit.
So, y'all got 2.5 weeks of school, of summer left. How y'all feel about that? Y'all ready to go back to school?
I want to go back to school when it's summertime, and then when it's school time, I can't wait till summer. That's how I feel. Only like the first week of school, that's it.
No, the first day of school.
The
first day of school, I don't know, because every time on the first day of school, we all be up early before it's time for us.
Yeah, because we be so excited, and then we'll be waking up and say like it's a morning yard or anything, and then it be feeling like it's a long time till school starts. Then once it's time for us to really get up, but then
we don't want to get up.
No, when it's time for us to really get up on the first day of school, it'd be taking a long time just for like the bus to come or anything. The bus don't come. Then we'd be so mad and stuff like that. But then after that first day of school, like after the first week or almost the first
month.
First
month.
Yeah. Then we just be so tired to get up. We don't want to get up for school. we don't want to go to school or anything. This year, we only like to go to schools on Fridays, and that's it.
Because it's fun Friday.
Yeah, it's fun Friday. Mm-hmm.
But I will go to school for the whole week so I can get dressed down.
Mm-hmm. Tell them about only if you go to private school.
Mm-hmm. What private school?
We went to private school.
We kind of liked the teachers, but at the same time I didn't. But it was fun there. They let us pie our teachers when we get a
good map score.
And I had a good map score. And then one day, if you got a good math score, they said you need to ride a limo and you go to McDonald's to get free ice cream.
But some of us didn't get to go because we wasn't there that whole week.
Only me and DJ only went, mm-hmm. And that was it.
And this year I'm going to third grade.
And this year I'm going to six.
And I'm going to seven.
And the twins going to first, TJ going to second, and DJ going to fourth.
No, he could feed going to fifth.
Oh, he going to fifth.
And then TJ going to ninth.
Yeah, ninth.
So we all going to the same school.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know what school we're going to for sure yet, but we do know a school that we might be going to.
Mm-hmm. But I like going to new schools, but then it feels kind of weird when they don't give you homework on the first day. I'll be wanting homework right on the first day.
At home, they give y'all homework for a whole week. Maybe the first week y'all didn't get homework.
Yeah, they didn't give us homework for the whole week, but I didn't like that. They only gave us homework for the parents. That's it. Yeah. They used to say, here's some homework for your parents, and your homework is to let your parents sign this. And that's it, and that was so boring.
I wanted homework on the first day. But I see why they didn't give us homework because they gotta tell us about the school.
The first week they just tell us about the school. But then when we do get homework after, like we get used to getting homework, we don't.
I have a question. Is the noodle spicy?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
It's hot.
Where's your mom?
Yeah, probably supposed to be AJ's.
Mooga, are you able to take it?
Sometimes I do like not getting homework, but sometimes I don't.
At Hope Fidelis, me and AJ used to be the only ones who had the most homework. We used to stay up all night to where our mama helping us on homework.
I had this big packet like this to do for the whole week. Like I gotta do 3 pages for Monday, then the next day I gotta do 4, next day I gotta do 5, the next day I go back to 3.
Dang,
it's mainly for math and reading, cause then in reading I gotta do a whole bunch of stuff.
But I had more homework than AJ. Some days, most of the days I had way more homework than AJ.
Yeah, you stayed up many nights. Trying to get it done.
I want to get one sheet.
Sometimes we get to get it done, and sometimes mom has to write letters to my teacher saying stuff like that. And sometimes I used to have a lot of homework that I used to forget some of my homework at home. And my mom had to text my teacher and tell me that.
That it's already done. She just forgot to bring it.
Because I had to read a book, like a chapter a day. I had to write. I had like a reading packet for that one day, a lot of math. Math was really hard for me.
No, math was easy for me.
I didn't like math.
I love math.
Math was my favorite subject. It was hard.
Mm-hmm.
But AJ, half the nights he used to stay with us, but most of the time it would be me or both of us.
Because in reading, we gotta read this chapter book, and it takes like 5 pages just to get to the next chapter. We gotta read like 2 chapters a day, and we gotta write about what we read in that chapter.
And sometimes, like a lot of schools, when they teach, say you have to work together and stuff, and when a lot of people don't listen and stuff, they add more homework, like writing to do and stuff, and then that used to irritate me a lot.
I want to get 2 sheets of homework, one for reading and one for math, and it'd be so easy. You want
to
get 2
The
questions.
Twins used to have the easiest homework. A little bit of homework.
I'll be asking my teacher when it's time for us for summer. I'd be asking my for the end of the school year for summer work. I'd be asking my teacher, can I get some math homework, so I could do something over math, some stuff for math.
Yeah, math is my favorite subject.
Yeah.
at school. To me, I don't think we should have summer homework, because what's the point of having summer and you still doing work? Because Hope for Daily is my friend told me that they gave them a big chapter book, like a big chapter book. She showed me too, and they had to read over the summer, and that was.
If I had to read over summer, it would have been boring.
Y'all didn't have to read over summer. I remember, y'all go to the library and get plenty of books when first.
Yeah, but at school they give us these boring books. They give us some boring books.
Oh, you're saying that sometimes you read what you want if the teacher don't make you read over something.
Well, I only like getting the math over this summer.
I don't like math. But my math teacher was his main teacher, and his reading teacher was my main teacher.
We used to switch classes and stuff. Like, she would go in my classroom, and I would go in her classroom. That's how it would go. And then when confetti, I do guided math, and I got to do guided reading, we would switch classes again. So we would switch classes twice. That was it. We would switch classes twice.
Here's a question. This is kind of like Q&A, I guess. How do you feel about being a middle schooler, AJ?
Oh, AJ.
Me?
It's fun. Yeah.
I get my own space now.
No.
What? What do you mean?
You do more work. You do.
Oh, it's more work? Funner. That would be easy for me.
I mean, you get to hang not around AJ, your not, friends a lot.
Well, let me tell you why.
It's fun.
What? Because if math, I mean, I'll be sitting there raising my hand and getting all the answers right.
He into elementary. That's not what a lot of middle school.
No, you get your own space. You get your own life. You get your own stuff.
Your teachers both times always said that you always get your work done. But you know, the talking thing. What about this year and the talking? They say every time you talked a lot. They say, but you was the only one that talked in your group that got your work done. And he was the second smartest in your classroom.
Yeah, so, I am. But
what about the talking? Are you going to slow down and talking?
I don't know how to stop talking.
I got
to
slow down my talking too.
I don't know how to stop talking. I talk a lot. No, this is what happened. I stopped talking towards the end of the school year.
But I'll be telling myself, I don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk. Please.
I stopped.
But I didn't end up talking.
Yeah. I'm the quietest one in my class.
Yeah, but she's the loudest one in the house. So weird.
Which is weird.
It's so weird.
But she's the quietest one in the classroom. But then she's the loudest one at home.
But she's probably the quietest one on camera too, but she's not.
But the one thing
none of her teachers believe us.
One thing I like is when you're talking and doing your work, it's more fun doing it that way than sitting there but staying quiet.
That's true. It was that way for me too. Because, the teacher used to tell my mama that I talk too much, but I always got my work done.
Yeah, I always get my work done.
I'm quiet.
And then when we had to do group projects, I'd be the main one telling people what to write and then what to put on the thing, so we don't have to get a lower grade on the stuff.
Yep. See. Mm-hmm.
That's the same thing. And then once my group get everything right, then everybody would come to me ask me how did y'all get this stuff right, but I know everything.
Yeah, but to me, when I talk, I used to stop talking towards the end of the school year, but you always got those friends that's always happy, you trying to write notes and talk, and trying to talk to you stuff, and then you don't want to be mean, and you end up doing the back and stuff, and then
I'm quiet in my
class. That used to make me in trouble a lot.
I'm quiet in my class.
Talking and writing,
it's irritating. Because you start writing down what you're talking about instead of what the assignment is.
Yeah,
I don't like people talking to me while I'm writing.
Exactly. Yeah. Mom, you know how many times I did that?
But no, I like it that way because and I used to get thoughts in my head. Like,
if I was in writing class,
and then we writing about something, like we get to write our own crazy ideas and stuff.
Yeah.
And then they talk it to me. It gives me more ideas what to write down.
Yeah, that's true. No, that is true. But I'm talking about when you got a thought in your head, and somebody talking to you,
and
you're writing down what they're saying and what you're thinking instead of what you wanted to put down.
I don't get messed up on
that. When that happened to me, you know how many times I feel embarrassed when that happened to me? Sometimes I just turn my papers in because I never get a chance to look over my paper because it's a lot to do. and we only got like 30 minutes and stuff like that, and it'd be taking so long for me. So when she give me back my paper, I'd be like, why am I trying to write it right? Because this happened to me a couple times when I got like a 75 or stuff like that, and I'd be reading over my stuff because she'd be underlining like that, and I'd be like, and I'd be showing my friends sometimes when that happens to me a couple times. So I started looking
at it. It happened to me about like once or twice.
I'm the slowest writer in my class.
I always am too.
Because when you slow at writing,
I like writing.
It gives you, if you slow at writing, it gives you more time to think about your stuff, and then instead of you writing fast and you getting sloppy and messed up and stuff. Yeah, that's what I like. I like going slow and taking my time doing it the right way instead of the messed up way.
That's true, me too.
Yeah, but a lot of people, since we only have a little bit of time, they try to hurry up and get their work done, but then the teachers always say if you're not done,
You can still stay back and do it.
They take away like the phone and stuff for us to do it.
No, not for me. He's Mr. Tucker let me sit at my desk and do it every time I want to do it.
My teacher don't do that to us. My teacher just be like, oh, but if y'all don't finish, she don't let us do it on reading and math and sometimes so we can just get done with our stuff. And then sometimes when it's recess time, she let us do it and then walk out and just go back to recess.
Yeah, but my teacher, so like she said if we get done with our other work, then we will be able to finish the work from like this morning and stuff like that. But I never get to get done finishing because we always have a little short time, and I don't even get done with the stuff that I'm supposed to be doing right now. And that time, then it'd be hard.
So me too, because once I write something, and once I'm writing something and doing the reading thing, then while I'm still writing that thing, I gotta go do the other thing too, because it's the same thing. You gotta like do three different steps, and I'm already doing step one. I'm still writing on step one, and she give me step two. I'm still writing step one. Then once I get there, I'm writing step one, and I'm writing the step two. I gotta get step three. Then now I gotta finish step two. Then now I gotta go do step three, and it'll take me a long time to do that.
And when the main time I'll be able to do it is when we at math, because math we get computer time and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But we have to go on Moby Max, and you have to get that done over to be the top people in math. So I've been on the top people in math almost all the time. So only on Moby Max, but not in the classroom. On Moby Max.
I've been on top of
because
penis,
I don't
math.
Like math. So just
I love math, but I'm not the top one. I'm the top one in reading, but not in math.
Reading, writing, and everything else is
pretty much
one.
My favorite thing about school is Fun math Friday, like math, and recess, and what a God.
I'm doing my news.
Yeah, my word of God is at the end of the day, like at the end of the day.
Mine
and
in the
we do morning prayer in the middle. I mean, in the end
of the day. After reading, we got a word of God, and then at 11 o'clock, we go to lunch.
The little kids, they be eating their lunch so early, because if they eat their lunch so early, because me and AJ, we the last people to eat lunch. So so how is that? We go to lunch at 12:45. So then how is everybody else eating? They be eating at 11 or something like that, because that's too early, or 10 or something. Because we be in there, we get done eating actually at 12:45. Done eating at 12:45. So that means they've been in there, because we...
Every
like at 5
or something,
or 6. What do you mean 6? We
don't
even have school that long.
No, tomorrow, you know how we could die eating breakfast? Because I be in there helping the little kids. They be doing some works and stuff. Then they'll be at lunch like at...
You talking about breakfast and you talking about lunch.
Y'all yeah, but we don't go to school at 5 or 6.
No, sure,
no. Y'all
get school at
like,
that.
We start school at
7:30. No, the doors open up at 7:30. We start school at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, we start school at 8 o'clock, but morning meeting is at 7:30 when we eat breakfast stuff.
So yeah,
where'd you get that time from?
No, but at 12 p.m. that's when we all start getting on the bus and stuff.
12 p.m. We don't get on the bus at 3:30.
It's
oh my God. we don't even get on the bus like 4 or 3:30, and we don't make it home till like 5 o'clock.
Why are you so confused?
No, because If we don't get on the bus, it's like 12 p.m. And then,
that's on Fridays.
That's on Friday, yeah, on Friday.
Fridays we
Friday be the best day ever because you get half a day.
And you get dressed down and stuff like that.
Question. Sorry, I got another question. Zaya, you still subscribing about your hair? It's not curly today?
It's straight.
Yeah, it's straight.
That's it. So much you don't have curls in your hair today.
Yeah, I don't like curls on my hair.
What? That's your
hair. You do like curls in your hair. It's got straightened.
Because you got spongy hair. It's like spongy.
They know if they are subscribers and they already tuned in, she has very spongy hair.
But it's in the ponytail.
Yeah. It's not telling you have natural hair. It's not a perm in your hair. It is a silk press.
Mm-hmm. This stuff hot. Oh, it ain't mine. The crushed red peppers are chewy and it's irritating. Because you know you got contraband. How do y'all like it when y'all go back to school? Like, do y'all think it's going to be fun or something?
Not so
If you keep much. Going to the same school, then you know.
I don't like going to the same school. I don't like that.
Me, y'all
sorry,
like switching
sorry
up
if you're my friend at the school, but you're just going to have to go to a new school because I can't do that.
Yeah, I like going to one school for a day, finish that whole school. Yeah, I like going to a new school.
I like adventuring different things. You already know everything. You got to relearn. You got to relearn everything because the new people don't even know the stuff, the routines and stuff. So you have to relearn it.
And then that's irritating.
But you go to a different grade, though.
Yeah, but they do the same thing. We've been to health days.
We've been to one school.
Lighthouse
two times. For the boys, we've been there three times.
For me, no.
For the boys, we've been there three times because.
I've been there one time.
Like, you know everything. But then we gotta keep relearning.
Okay,
Lighthouse was K-5, and then the Hope for Dads, that was in first. Then the next year, I'm in second.
What was your favorite year so far? What was your favorite grade so far?
First.
Let me think. So, Ms. Wycliffe had me teaching when I was in second grade.
Second grade.
Ms. Rocker? Yeah. Ms. Rocker was the best teacher.
She was my teacher in fourth grade.
Sorry, guys.
Mm-hmm. But she a good teacher. She got a pet, what's her name?
Guinea pig.
Yeah, guinea pig.
She be letting us
see her guinea pigs and stuff.
My favorite grade is, I don't think I have a favorite grade, cause none of them.
I don't like boy teachers, and sometimes I don't like.
I didn't like fifth grade. Wait, who did I? Okay, no, I don't like. I definitely didn't like fifth grade. I don't like sixth grade. Was kind of actually. I'll just say sixth grade, even though I didn't like it.
What about you, Alaya?
They only been in school for 2 years.
I know.
They only got K-5 or K-4.
You like K-5 or first grade, buddy.
I mean, K-5 or K-4.
Or K-4, I'm sorry. Because
they finna go to first grade.
I know.
They say K-4.
K-4.
Because
I
got
to wait for
a lot
of stuff.
And they got to get naps and snacks.
And they went to go pick out pumpkin stuff, but the rest of them did it.
TJ, what was your favorite?
None of them. Because in K-5, the teachers bailed too much. And in first grade, the teacher loves too much.
No, Miss Thomas, not. Teacher, what's your favorite grade?
The teachers don't get. Yeah, because you were.
What's your favorite grade? Homeschool.
Amen.
Dear, what's your favorite grade?
Homeschool.
Like me, first is my favorite grade.
First, because DJ had.
His favorite grade was what?
First, because he had that one teacher. That remember he said he wanted to flop? Remember he said he
wanted to. Up in third.
What else up in third?
My first fifth grade, it was my favorite.
That's not funny. At Princess Conference, when I was my mama. Because I was the only one who went to Princess Conference, so I go mainly to all the Princess Conference.
And DJ wrote down.
And DJ wrote down on that paper when his teacher was showing my mama, I want to fly when I grow up. And you know how funny that was? That was really funny.
He had Miss Davis. Yeah, Miss Davis.
That was the first grade.
Yeah, you showed us.
He said, no, he didn't say he wanted to fly when he get older. He said, I can't wait to fly when I get older.
Yeah,
I saw that in the third. He said he couldn't wait to fly when he get older. It's different. So, obviously, someone told him when you get older, you will start to fly. That's why it was funny.
Well, what was you? You can go skydiving. That's kind of flying.
That's kind of flying. Yeah.
No, it's diving in the elevator.
And then passing away.
You still believe that adults can fly?
How old is it? You can build. You can build it. You can build it. You can build wings.
What's the rocket?
I can turn 9 too.
You want to fly like naturally?
Okay, to build wings. And then just build the wings.
That's not naturally. That's technology.
That's true. Dude, all you need to do is go like this and build enough air, you can fly. Did we already ask TJ what his.
TJ asked him what?
Did we already ask TJ
what his. Yeah, he said none. Great.
Because I'm K5.
If you had to pick one today, what would
you do? None. Can't even choose.
Okay.
Half first grade.
Okay, guys, we're going to wrap up this video. Don't forget to subscribe, give a big thumbs up. And turn on your post notifications so you can see my videos.
And yeah, for scale alone, please be out day 4110 and start family mining.
Did y'all get to finish our moves at least?
I did. Both of them did, but I didn't.
Oh.
Yeah, so comment down below if you like hot and spicy noodles. And comment down below
if you like hot stuff.
And what was your favorite grade out of all the grades you've been to so far?
And do you like going back to school?
And if you only been in one grade, yeah.
And if it's not your favorite,
yeah, you game. Still
can cry. Ask them up. What they do over the summer? Is anybody ready to go back to school?
Yeah, anybody ready to go back to school?
If we have any kids subscribers.
Yeah. But the girls can still comment and say what was their favorite grade when
was
it was a kid.
My favorite grade in school
was high school, wasn't it?
No, it was fifth grade.
Exactly. My first fifth grade.
Why? Because I received an award. I think I received 31 awards that year.
31
award. My mama was very smart.
Yeah.
I am too.
She was like the top 10 inside the United States of the smartest.
That was in middle school though.
But we still got all of our awards and everything. We got like spelling test awards.
I got every last one of y'all
awards. Yeah, a lot. Me and AJ got most of spelling tests and stuff awards because we don't. Because
me and Fatty got the same spelling words. In fifth and sixth grade.
I didn't like that. In the beginning, they made us have the same spelling words with different grades. And then,
no, at first they let it that we had different
spelling words. Yes, different spelling words. But now they start putting us like, we got the same spelling words like we in the same class and stuff. So
me and Aja used to do. For me to remember the words.
So me and Aja used to work together on our spelling words when we was at home.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Y'all did. That's right. I remember that.
And remember me, but they didn't test us at the same time. They test fifth grade differently and us differently. Mm-hmm. And me and you used to have the same sentences and stuff as our homework sometimes because.
No, I'll be wanting to write my own. I'll be writing my own.
Sometimes, yeah. So, anyways, guys.
We got off track quick.
Yeah.
In first grade, I test on the computers or in the class.
Okay,
don't forget to subscribe, give thumbs up, and turn your post notification bell so you can see my video. I'm here for a scary Friday and a lonely peace. We are there 41 and 10.
That's our family reminder. Bye.